Italian Futurism 1909 to 1944, Reconstructing the Universe is an exhibition that presents the full breadth of Italian Futurism outside of Italy for the first time, and certainly for the first time in the United States. Viewers will experience not only work from the teens with which they may be familiar, but discover that the futurists were active in the 20s and the 30s and even into the early 40s and produced not only painting and sculpture, but design, some film and photography, architecture, much theater, performance, a great deal of literature. The Futurist Reconstruction of the Universe, which is the subtitle of the show, is a manifesto written by Giacomo Balla, Fortunato De Pero, and the idea was that the whole world was meant to be futurist. And we have conceived the show in that way and taken another main futurist principle, which is to put the spectator at the center of the artwork, and thus, in entering the Guggenheim, being surrounded by the ramps, you are at the center of this reconstruction of the universe, or at the total work of art, l'opera d'arte totale, which is another important theme. In terms of the beginnings of futurist art, they're already trying to apply these ideas about speed and dynamism and simultaneity, so we see a lot of rushing forms and swirling, and there's a lot of thought invested in how to depict motion and movement. After having figured out how to really depict these kinds of modern ideas, we see what are called the heroic years, which are the years of the teens leading up into World War I, basically. Once World War I breaks, one of the important things that the futurists and other Italians wished for was to enter the war in order to get back the lands under Austrian rule, and this was a movement called interventionism. So part of the warmongering we associate with futurism has to do with this very nationalistic desire to make the country whole again. After World War I, that is when Mussolini starts gaining a lot of power. Marinetti and Mussolini know each other. They were part of the same groups that were proto-fascist. Then by 19, the fascist party, or what will become the fascist party, is founded. By 1920, Marinetti and the futurists break from that because they disagree with a series of things. So after that, there is this sort of uneasy and complex relationship between the futurists and the fascists, and Mussolini's interest in the arts didn't coincide with Marinetti's own. After the war, just as there is a return to order and there are artists who become much more classicizing and more figurative, even the futurists turn to a more figurative type of idiom, but one that's more mechanically informed. By the early 1920s, you have Manifesto of Mechanical Art, Arte Meccanica. Marinetti very early on wants to involve technology, the machine, because the machine is a huge theme for them, of course, like the car, the train, the plane, but any kind of mechanical thing that could represent modernity. They loved the industrial city, whereas other people were escaping it. The futurists embrace it. By the 1930s, we reached this focus on aerial themes. So you have aeropittura, aeroceramica, which aerial ceramics, aerodanza, aerial dance, fotodinamismi, which is a type of aerial photography. They would actually take pictures from planes, and you have swirling views of Roman ruins. You get some wonderful aeropittura in a group of works by Benedetta, aka Benedetta K. Marinetti, called the Five Syntheses of Communications, which are very large-scale works of telegraph, radio, maritime communication, aerial, of course. These were commissioned for the post office in Palermo for their conference room, and this happens in the 1930s, and that brings you really through to the end of the movement, which happens just after Marinetti's death at the end of 44.